Hi, welcome to the episode 2 of Azure Fundamental full course. In this session, we will discuss about what is the CapEx, what is OpEx, and what are the difference between them. So let's identify the difference between the CapEx and the OpEx. So let's understand what is the CapEx. CapEx stands for capital expenditure, which you do at the start of your project. In an IT company, the expenditure would be buying the servers, buying the networking and hardwares. So that will be the cost. If you look at it from the capital expenditure perspective, you have to buy everything at the start and you own it. The moment you own it, the problem is of the maintenance. So if you own all your servers and hardwares, all the maintenance cost is also is your headache. So you have to bear that cost and the resources on it. And the third problem with the CapEx is if you have to, at the start of the project itself, you have to identify what could be the number of, amount of a workload which will become in future. So let's say you assume that your website will have a 1 million user. So you buy the hardware corresponding to that workload, but eventually if it get failed and you didn't get so much attraction of the user, then your money will get wasted in this huge infrastructure cost. Now let's look at the OPEX side. What is OPEX? OPEX stands for operational expenditure. Here you don't pay anything at the start. You only pay for what you use on the rental basis. So assume that you are starting a new software company with a small 4 or 5 people. So what you will do is you will take 4 or 5 small machines at this start on rent. And as you grow along, you will keep taking more machines, more hardware on rental basis. So the advantage is at the start, your cost will be less. If you get success and you need more infrastructure, you can anytime build it on the runtime by taking it on rental basis. Third, you don't need any maintenance because you will take it on rental basis. So probably it will be the cloud provider's problem who is providing you the resources. So he will take care of the maintenance and support. Now let's look at the difference between the capital expenditure and the operational expenditure. If it in terms of the cost, in capital expenditure, we have high cost at the start, and in the OPEX, we have a very low cost at the start of the project. And more of it, the cost in the operation would always be optimum because you will pay for what you use. Another is the maintenance cost. The maintenance cost will be very small in OPEX, but in the CAPEX side, it will be high because you are the owner and you have to maintain your hardwares and infrastructure. Value over time, you know that the hardware cost reduces or depreciated over the period of time. The price of one laptop is the 5 years ago and today is not the same. Your technology changes and the 5 years ago, whatever you bought is of hardly of 1/5 of it, right? So if you buy the infrastructure, then you will lose the money because of depreciation. But in OPEX, you won't lose anything because you take it on rent. Last is handle the dynamic demands. So if your demands is high, you can get more infrastructure on OPEX, or if demand is low, you can reduce down it. So you can adjust based on your demand in the OPEX side, but you cannot do it at the CAPEX side. So all the cloud providers generally provide you the OPEX facility because they provide everything on your rental basis. So you can get the OPEX on the cloud, but there is a way where you can use the cloud as a CAPEX as well, where you buy the reserved quantity. Sometimes there is in Azure as well, you can reserve the resources for, let's say, 3 years or 4 years or 5 years contract. So then it can also get converted into CapEx side as well. So by this, we almost reached the end of our session, but don't miss to visit my website where you can go and check what we have learned so far. There are a few questions here, there, so you can check your what the knowledge that you have gained so far. So till then, goodbye. Keep learning.